Today, what we'll do, we'll get started with this thing formally. What is this? Intensity transformation and spatial filtering. Okay. So you are listening, right? Any issues? 1 second. Okay. Okay. Yes, intensity transformation and spatial filtering. You can listen, right? Somebody ping me. Okay, just if somebody, if possible, you share the link of this class, you know, because like I told you, I am unable to do that because I have changed my. Okay, thank you. Okay, so this is actually module 2, okay, in your syllabus, in the textbook, this is chapter 3. So in the chapter Digital Image Processing by Gonzalez. That is your prescribed textbook. Okay. So soft copy is available online. Not so clear one. So don't be in a hurry to buy any textbooks. You should buy the book which is of better paper quality. Okay. So otherwise the images also won't be clear. Shall we get started? So when we say transformation and filtering, so what are we operating on? So yesterday we saw how images are actually. So when I say we are operating on images, actually we are operating with numbers only. But usually we will be manipulating unsigned integers. Okay, usually we will be manipulating unsigned integer. As and when situation occurs, we will convert those unsigned integer into double or a normal signed integer, do the manipulation, and while displaying, we will once again convert back them back to unsigned integer and display. Okay, from 0 to 255. That is one thing. Moreover, whatever we did in the fifth semester in DSP, same things we'll be doing here. Only difference would be this is a two-dimensional array. Okay. So images are either two-dimensional or three-dimensional. If at all it is a simple x comma y grayscale image, it will be two dimensional. If it contains red, green and blue also, then it is a three dimensional image usually. Okay, so what we will do, we'll stick to two dimensional images only. The same things apply to three dimensions also. Okay, the same things apply to one more dimension. That would be that, and even whatever you do here, same thing is applied to videos also usually, because let's not talk about video anyway. Okay. So two terms here. One is transformation. Okay, one term is transformation, another term is filtering. Let us try to understand what is the difference. Transformation means you have seen the pixels, right? Pixels, horizontal, pixels, vertical. When you are operating on an individual pixel value, you are increasing the strength of it, reducing the strength of it, adding plus 5, subtracting plus 5, minus 5, or you are taking logarithm of it, whatever you do. If at all you are doing it to a single pixel only, whatever action it took on the pixel, that will be called as a transformation. Whereas when you take action on the filter, okay, on the particular pixel based on the neighboring pixel values, okay, your value of the current pixel is determined by values of the pixels in the neighborhood. Okay, if this pixel here, this pixel, all the four neighbors, all the eight neighbors, if at all such is your the measure of determining the current pixel value, right? If at all I take everybody's internal marks and I simply give 2 marks grace to everybody, that would be a marks transformation. Okay. Whereas the calculation of what VTU did now to determine the fifth semester students' external marks, they did it based on the previous semester's external marks. Okay. That's not a transformation. That is a filtering. That means the current decision they have taken based on the previous values or some other values and guess the value. Okay, what this particular thing? Transformation and filtering. By the way, this particular topic here, we talk about spatial filtering, because in the next topic we will be talking about frequency domain filtering. just like the way there was time in the time domain signals, whatever it is, voltages, currents, and so on and so, audio signals, right? They were all time domain signals. Mm-hmm. Similarly, all images are said to be spatial signals, something in the X domain and something in Y. Okay, horizontal and vertical values. So there were two ways of doing things here. So as and we all know, right, what important role frequency played when we are analyzing the signals in the time domain, right? The frequency aspects were very much important. Human perception, right? And all, it was much responsive to frequency. Same is the case with images also. We'll see that. Same is the case with images also. Humans are not that much sensitive to large changes in the pixel intensities, but gradual changes only humans are sensitive to. That is why here also, whenever you are trying to manipulate images, we can do it in the spatial domain, X and Y as it is, or we can also do it in frequency domain. Okay, so in this particular chapter, we'll be studying spatial domain filtering. In the next chapter, we'll be studying about the frequency domain filtering. Okay, this is the initial step of several process involved in digital image processing. Okay, this will be the first and very, very trivial, but also very, very interesting steps. If at all you are well versed with, in this particular chapter, we will be studying some basics about how to access images from computer for your manipulation. If at all you can do it in MATLAB, you can do it probably in Python also, you can do it probably in C also, because you should know how they are stored and how they are to be manipulated. What should be done is something that we are trying to learn here. How it should be done and all, yeah, fine. That you can do it depending on whichever the programming language you learn. But what should be done and why, that we'll try to learn here. Okay. So what all things we want to do? So as I said, the background has been told. The difference between transformation and filtering. Then we'll study what sort of transformations are we talking about. Then we will study an important thing called as histogram. Okay. Then we'll study this thing called as histogram. Have you come across this term histogram anywhere? Somebody, have you come across the term histogram anywhere? Histogram. No, I guess, right? Somebody is in the graph. Okay. So where actually? Where in graphs? Did you have it in statistics or somewhere? I can't relate something from our syllabus. Okay, but you're right, Sushma. It's something related to graph, the representation. Okay, let us see. Okay, let us study that. Then we'll study something of spatial filtering. And spatial filter, what sort of filters we'll usually study? We'll study smoothing filters and we'll study sharpening filters. Smoothing filters are averaging, or what we say, low pass filter. Sharpening filters are not necessarily high pass filters, but it's a process which involves both smoothing also and somehow making it look, much more crispier. We'll see that. Okay, the chapter is interesting. Let us see how does it go. Okay, so here we are in this particular topic. So background. So here author is trying to tell what is meant by intensity transformation. As the author is telling, if at all are trying to, operate only on the single pixel. Okay. So you are trying to manipulate some operation. Maybe you are adding 50 to an intensity, or you are applying logarithm to an, whatever it is. If at all you are doing it on a current image, then it is a transformation. If at all you are taking the neighborhood into consideration, then it is filtering. Okay, got it. One second. Okay, sorry for that interruption. Now, am I audible? Okay, let us continue. Let us continue. Audible, right? So call came. So net also might have. Okay. So now, let us see transformations and filtering. Let us see what sort of transformations we are talking about. Okay. So transformation can be one pixel basis. Okay. What sort of things you can do? So you might want to do several sorts of thing with pixel intensities. So example can be anything from this term contrast stretching to thresholding. What is this contrast stretching and what is this thresholding? What should I say? What is contrast stretching and what is thresholding? So let us see. Contrast stretching, currently I am not in a state to explain you this. Okay, let me try. Now suppose there is a particular image. Okay, there is a particular image and you want to differentiate. You are in, the topic has not come yet. It is there in this particular chapter only. As and when you go there, we will see that. There is this thresholding. Okay, threshold I can try to explain you. Now suppose you have this particular white sheet. Okay, you have this white sheet and you want to scan this particular thing. On that particular white sheet, you have written something with a black ink. Okay, on a white sheet, you have written something on a black ink. And you wanted to scan this particular thing, send it to your friend somewhere. Okay, but what happened? You folded the sheet. You folded the sheet. Okay, and you put it in your pocket. Okay, and in your pocket, maybe there was some dirt or something. You kept it on table. So what happened? When you fold it, there were some shadows popping up, right? So whenever you fold, there are lines of shadows that when you take the photo of it, that would be gray. Okay. And then afterwards, it gets wet sometimes. So a sheet, when it gets wet, a white sheet, it has some blue tint to it, right? It gets some blue tint to it. So afterwards, what happens is, so suddenly when you digitize this entire thing, then your picture is not so differentiable because it doesn't simply contain a white and black. Okay, so ideally when you write it on a white background sheet with a color that is black, what happens is, now suppose I have this particular a sheet with a white background. Now say in this particular sheet, say I tend to write something. Okay, I write it in white sheet. Okay, as I said, white sheet. Now let me write something in this. Okay, now let me write something is in this particular sheet of writing. Okay, I tend to digitize. I want to digitize this particular sheet. Now, if at all I scan this particular sheet, I expect this thing to be all white intensities, 255, 255, 255 for white, and all black, I want them to be zero. But what happens usually is you tend to get, you fold the sheet somewhere. And when you fold the sheet, what happens is, you fold it four times and want to put it in your pocket. In between, there are these shades of gray pop up. Okay. Shades of blue, maybe. Shades of gray, usually they are. Shades, they pop up. Okay. And then what happens is, then afterwards, sometimes there will be some dirt. Okay. There will be some dirt accumulation here and there and something. Okay. Now you are in a situation. How do we digitize this? Then what you intend to do? So how do you plan on doing this? So what I will do is, I will digitize this, then I will keep a threshold of 180. Okay, assuming that all these shades, whatever that have come, if at I am assuming that anything above 220, 230 shall be considered as white, or anything above 150 or 140 shall be considered white, anything below that shall be considered black. Okay, so what happens? I go on varying the threshold. Now suppose if these intensity, if all the shade intensity is something like 140, okay, if they are something like 140 maybe, then I may try to remove all this effects. Okay, not so convincing explanation, by the way. I'm not so convincing, right? Let us see as and when the situation comes in. Okay, I will definitely convince you with MATLAB. Okay. This class only, probably. Okay, so there can be, remember the terms, okay, contrast stretching and thresholding. Let us see, where do we intend to apply this. Okay, let us see which are the examples that we have. Okay, so intensity transformations. So what sorts of basic intensity transformations we have? There is something called a logarithmic transformation. Then there is inverse log transformation. Then there is something called as nth power, and then there is something called as nth root. What is this thing? Then there is an image negative. Where do you use an image negative? Author has explained each of these things. Okay, let us see image negative first. Then let us see what is this log and what is this power thing and why they are used. Okay, so let us see one by one. Now one thing is what author wants you to know is whatever it is, but finally you are operating only on the single pixel. You are operating on single pixel and you are trying to manipulate the value. Okay, so let us see the first one, image negatives. Okay, image negatives are fun, right? We have seen negatives in, you used to go to photo studios and all earlier, some 8-10 years back, they would give us the negatives, right? And you will see some 20 year back, your parents, some function was there, they would take the photo, Kodak camera, they would give you the negatives, right? There is some thing, okay, so they would give you the negative, from that negative the positive things can be recovered, something like that. Okay, so recently I think somebody had posted in the group, I don't know, to convert those negatives into actual images by Kodak had put up some app or something. If at all you take a snap of it, it will convert the negative to positive. Okay, have you come across it? Have you come across that particular thing? Somebody ping me, do you know what a photo negative is? Can somebody, have you come across something called as a negative? And okay, so I hope you might remember in your closet somewhere, in your parents, some old boxes and cupboards, you will find those, you know, strips of something negative, and everybody looks like ghosts there. Then afterward, there are easier methods, okay, to convert them to positive. Okay, anyway, so where do we use it, by the way? So negative of an image is simply nothing but every 255 intensity shall be converted to zero, and every zero shall be converted to 255. That means take the maximum value. L layer is the number of intensity levels. If at all you are allocating 8 bits to a pixel, 2 to the power 8 is equal to 255. So totally from 0 to 255, you get 256 intensity levels. So when you say negative, everyone shall be converted to zero. Every zero shall be converted to one. Or here in case, every brightest white shall be converted to darkest dark. Every light gray shall be converted to dark gray. So how do you do this? 256 minus one minus whatever the intensity of the pixel. And that should work. Why do they do that, by the way? Sometimes had author said, so here is an image of a mammogram where in the original image, you cannot conclude things. Whereas when you take the negative, probably there was some lump or something, which might be a detecting thing. Okay, so whichever the method gives you nice results for analysis. Okay, so sometimes the actual images give an analysis. Sometimes the negatives give a better analysis. Okay, so probably that's what the author is telling. Sometimes the negatives of an image gives you a better method of analyzing. Okay. So once this topic is done, we'll go to MATLAB and we'll try that thing. Okay. Then what is the next thing? The second thing what we usually do is log transformation. The next thing what we want to do is log transformation. So why do we do this log transformations, by the way? Okay. What do the logarithm things do? Logarithm, let us see. If at all I have a number 100, a logarithm, it will give me a value 2. If at all it is 10, it will give me a value of 1, right? Log 10 is 1. Log 100 is 2. Log 1000 is 3. Are you getting what is happening here? What is a log curve? See, this is not, you know, the way I'm explaining is not so convincing. Let us see here. Let us see the graphs. What do log transformations do? See here, what logarithm does, it linearly, see, this is a linear curve, every input as it is, simply put to output. Logarithm, what it does, it it amplifies the lower values and it suppresses the higher values. Okay, it amplifies the lower values and suppresses the higher values. So why do we need that sometimes? Where do we need it? Actually, in the dark. Now see here, next image here. See this particular thing. There is an image. What sort of image is this, by the way? Let us see that. Okay, there is an image here, and in this particular image, there are some details. There are details. Okay, there are details here also. There are details in this part also. Here also, there are a lot of details. But unfortunately, these intensities in the end. See, let me tell you once again. White is something nearer to 255. Light gray, white are something above 180, 220, 245, and so and so. Dark gray and black, they occupy usually 0, 20, 30, 50, 80, and so and so. So if at all I want to be able to differentiate the values in these corners where the intensities are much darker, this is fine. But if I want to see the details of this, then what sort of transformation should I apply? Then what should I do is, I shall go for a transformation. I cannot simply subtract 20 or I cannot add 20. If at all I have a pixel intensity, something like say there is an image, there is an image and there are some intensities, something like 20. Okay, there is 20 and there is 40 here. Okay, this is darkest gray. This is little better, lesser evil gray. Okay, and then there is 240, 250 intensities here. Okay, now just because you want to see these values, if at all I simply choose to add 50 to this number, add 50 to intensity. What's going to happen when I simply add 50 to these dark intensities? They will become bright. But then all the values, say if at all I add 250 plus 50 to every number, okay, if at all I add here, I go to this particular value, simply add plus 50. Then what's going to happen is all the dark images simply become lighter. Okay, fine. Then you get to see these values. But then what happens to the lighter ones? All the values above 205, all the values 206, 207, 208, 231, 242, everything will simply become 255, right? And here you will end up getting a white patch. So if at all you try to get the details in the darker region, the brighter region details will be saturated. If at all there is too much brightness here and we are not able to differentiate between these intensities, and say you subtract something, then the darker regions become much darker. Okay, this is the problem of saturation and noise, remember. So simple addition is not a solution. In such case, we go for a non-linear transformation. Okay, something which is having a transformation which is have a different measure of treatment for lower intensities, different measure of treatment for higher intensities. Log it is. There is a, so whatever you do, you take whatever your intensity value, add one to it, because log zero is minus infinity. Okay. That is why if the darkest black is there, make it one. So just to avoid minus infinity, then scale it by certain constant. Scale it by certain constant. Okay. So this is the second thing. By the way, this image, whatever I have shown here, this is the Fourier spectrum, okay, of any image. It's a Fourier spectrum. So Fourier spectrum, you remember when I was explaining DFT or the Fourier transform, I said that at zero, there will be DC. And as and when I go towards the right side, there will be high frequency constant, right? DC will be there at the origin. Similarly, for this particular image, which is a Fourier transform of a two-dimensional thing, this value in the center is the DC or the bias. And as and when we move towards the diagonal edges, they represent the higher frequencies. Okay. And this corner, it contains the highest of the frequencies. Unfortunately, what happens is, since the variation of intensity is so large, all these higher values are simply not differentiable from each other. That is why what author has done here, not only author, you will be doing this thing. If at all you want to analyze the Fourier spectrum, you have to apply the log transformation. Okay. So two types of transformation I told you, right? One is that of your negatives, right? One is that of your negatives. Then I explained to you the log transformation. Why do we use log transformation? When we want to amplify the lower intensities and rather suppress the higher intensities, not saturate. Okay. They also will get the treatment, but lower values will be amplified better. Logarithm. Similarly, what about the root treatment then? What about the root treatment? So if at all similarly, there was this other case, right? So if log is used to amplify, okay, to get a better perspective of the lower values and rather suppress the higher value. Similarly, on the other side, there is inverse log. Inverse log does the other thing. It suppresses the lower values and rather it encourages the values in the center and maybe at the higher values. Okay. Okay. Let us see what next. Now, what we'll do is we'll go to MATLAB. Okay. Before going to there, let me show you what sort of other transformation do. There is something called as power law transformation, the gamma transformation. Where do we use this gamma transformation? Okay, gamma correction. Have you heard of this term gamma correction somewhere? Somebody using those big cameras, or maybe what you can do is you can see your TV. Okay, have you seen closely your TV connections and the different channels? CRT TVs usually. Nowadays, I don't know, LCD TV and all. Just anyway, be curious and see your TV settings. What all different settings do we have? Anyway, let us see. What is this gamma correction? Now you can see this is an anti-log operation. Okay, this is a anti-log operation. You take your intensity, bias it with certain value, then you apply the root. Okay, so if at all this gamma is 2, this is a square law transformation. Then afterward, this can be 3, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, you can see here. So many measures possible here. So now what we'll do? Let us go to MATLAB. Okay. Did you got this particular thing? Just as we apply log, if at all I take the intensity and I square it. Otherwise, I take the power of 0.4, power to 0.4, then it becomes a gamma transformation. Okay. You might be wondering now, the value is 255. 255 to the power 2. It's a very big number, right? 255 to the power 2, 2 to the power 1.5 is a very big number. As I told you, what should we do? Convert the intensities to double. Then you do the transformation. Okay. Then you do the transformation. It's not applied on unsigned integers. Okay. Okay. Now, without wasting much time, what we'll do? We will go to. Okay. See here. Okay. There is something interesting. Gamma corrections. Where do they? As I was telling, in the TVs. Okay. CRT TVs had intensity to voltage response, that is a power of function, it seems. Okay, so whenever you take an image on a TV, you had to apply the gamma correction. Okay, so what would happen is whatever that is seen on a TV, when you want to see it on an image, then you have to apply the correction. Okay, Okay, we'll talk about this tomorrow. Now I have some 8 minutes. Okay, what I will do, I will just migrate to MATLAB now. By the way, you just go and check what is this gamma correction. You might have seen this thing. Even in ads, they are quoting gamma correction and all for TVs. Okay. So for the time being, let us go to MATLAB now. I will share you the MATLAB screen now with you. Let me share you with you the MATLAB screen. Okay. Now we are in MATLAB. What all things do we want to do now? So what we'll do here in MATLAB, let us try this image negative. Okay. So what is an image negative, by the way? So can you see this MATLAB screen? I hope you can, right? Image negative in the sense, let me read an image. Okay. What is the command? I am read is the command. Now, just like I did what I did yesterday, today I am not going to read a color image. I will read a black and white image, the standard image called as cameraman.tif, whatever it is, either whether it's a JPG, BMP or TIF. When you read it here, it will be MATLAB simply converts them into pixels. Okay. I read the image, and here you can see, I read the image. It is showing here the data type. It is showing 512 x 512 unsigned integer. 512 x 512 unsigned integer. Okay. So now what I will do? Shall I display the image? I will display the image. What does the image? How does it look like? Okay. IamShow is the command. Okay. IamShow is the command. Can you listen, somebody? My internet connection is unstable. It is showing. IamShow. Iam. Now, new share the figure. Okay. That is, now you can see this particular image, right? You can see this particular image. Now let me share my screen itself with you. Okay, now can you see the image? Now what we'll do, we'll do the image negative of this. Image negative in sense, what should we do? Shall we, let us see what is this, what are these numbers made of? You can see here, what are these intensities? You can see all this, this particular image is made of all the intensities. So when I say image negative, what should I do? Every 82 shall be replaced by 255 minus 82. Every 82 shall be replaced by, not every intensity, shall be replaced by 255 minus that intensity. So that if at all intensity is 0, it becomes 255 minus 0. That is 255. And if at all it is 255, it becomes 0. Shall we do that? Shall we do that? So, okay. So now what I will do, IMN, image negative is equal to image, whatever it is, simply I will, what is the value? 255 minus image. I hope I am done here. Okay, I am done. So shall I am show, let me have one more figure. So, I already have this figure here. You can see my screen, right? Somebody ping me, please. You can see my screen, right? Somebody just ping me. Somebody? Okay. Okay, huh? Thank you. So, I am show. Which one? The negative. IMN is the name what I gave it. Okay. So, there is the negative of it. Okay, so figure I am sure. Okay, I want to have them. Okay, so this is the negative, this is the positive. So if at all you have the negative somewhere in your closet, maybe if at all you take a snap of it, and then I feel if at all you simply do this transformation, all those negatives can be converted to positive. What do you think? Don't you think so? You got some old pictures of yours. You take them very nice clarity, digitize it and apply this particular transformation, and maybe your image negative can be recovered into image positive by this kind of transformation. Right? That was cool, right? Anyway, that's not the intention. Okay. Image negatives, they had certain application to it. Those times, even today, as I told you, medical images, the doctors, they prefer sometimes image negatives rather than the actual images. That was the first thing. The second thing what I was telling was the what is the need for log transformation. For that, what we'll do, the need for log transformation, what we'll do, let me show you. Okay, there is a particular image. Okay, there is a particular image where let me search if there are in some sensible images. So there is an image called as letter.bmp. okay, see, here I am reading that particular image. It's called letters.bmp. it's a standard image. Okay, letters.bmp is a standard image. And now let me show you how the image looks like. So I'm not displaying it directly here. This is an image called letters.bmp. okay, letters.bmp is this particular image I am showing. It's a test image. Okay, it's a standard test image. So now I want to see the Fourier transformation. I want to analyze this in the frequency domain. How does this look like in a frequency domain? So what I will do to convert it to frequency domain, I will do this particular exercise. What should I do? Converting frequency domain, two-dimensional Fourier transform I have to apply. FFT2. Okay, I apply the Fourier transform and I end up getting something like, I applied. Okay, Fourier transformers applied. Then afterwards, I have to perform. I am sure. Let me display the thing. How does it look like? Okay. Let me display. Okay. Once the class ends, I want you to join once again with the same ID and password. Okay. I will restart the class. Okay. Just for 2 minutes. Okay. Now see here. Image is getting displayed, right? Can you make some sense out of this particular thing? Except for the fact that, can you make some sense out of this? But do you see some pattern here? You can see this entire image is symmetric. This entire image is, whatever other things may be, it is symmetric. You can see the values here, they all seem to be mirror images. Okay. Now let us see, where do we use log transformation? That is a very bad image and it is very highly ill performed image. Okay. Now let me go to some other images whichever have somewhat better. Okay. Now here I have same image applied, I am sure. Okay. Now I will once again display the particular image. Okay. Not so convincing. The image is not so convincing. Okay. For some reason it's not convincing. Then what I will do is I will apply logarithm to it. Okay. Now also the image is not so good.